two brand new figures, giving you a kind of quick review of each of them. Hercules is a fan channel exclusive and it comes in at 6.5 inches or 16 centimeters. Quicksilver from the Age of Ultron is 6 inches or 15 centimeters overall. Two pretty solid figures. Let's look at Hercules first with this huge retro card art here. Going back to the kind of Toy Biz era, we get the Hercules logo up the top. Big hero there with his mace, golden mace. Alright, there's not a great deal I can really tell you about these figures other than they're pretty good, but nothing too incredibly stunning. But if you're a Hercules fan, you're getting another chance at this action hero. I was more introduced to this guy from Deadpool comics than I was actually reading his comics alone. But the Hero of Olympus is there, and if you want to read a little bit more on the back, there's not much else, just all warnings, don't stick it up your nose, and interestingly some recycle stuff just telling you a little bit more about it, which Hasbro are making some good inroads into, which is pretty good. Now, Hercules comes with two head swaps here. Let me just get the light on this so we can show you a little bit better here. Because they're really dissimilar. There's really not a great deal of difference between them. Let me just fix this lighting here one second. That should be better. Come on, say cheese. So you can see really you've got a kind of smarmy head here, which I really like, and this one here, which kind of looks like he's just kind of literally crapped his pants. It doesn't really too much teeth going on. I don't know. It's just. It's kind of weird. So the smarmy Hercules that we know, the kind of super duper I'm an I wonderful hero, it works. It's good. It's solid. I really like it as the kind of standard head, and the hair looks great over the head sculpt. We did get a Hercules not that long ago, and it wasn't too dissimilar, but there's definitely been some improvements in the body. But as you can see, it's just not a dramatically different face. If it had been a more aggressive face, I would have got it, but it's so subtly different. Apart from the eyebrows. So there you go, you decide which one you like, leave a note in the comments, let us know about chat the pants or happy smarmy face. Not much difference really. He comes with a couple of swap out hands, so you can have basically either two gripping hands or two fist hands. So decide which you want. This one is holding the golden mace, which is pretty plain. Not much going on. I picked these up, by the way, at DarkSideToys.com. Beautiful packaging, and they're just a wonderful bunch. If you've never bought anything from them, where have you been? They ship pretty much around the globe, and very fair shipping prices, especially to other countries such as the UK, Australia, New Zealand, etc. So check them out, as well as mostly free shipping in the US, certainly for a lot of products and a lot of prices. So Hercules is looking as if he's obviously hit the gym. He's absolutely beefed out, loads of muscles as to be expected, and pretty standard articulation. We're still on the Pintec here, which is unusual because I think this is a brand new figure in many ways. Huge big belt, rippling thighs, pinless tech on the legs, I should note, which is nice. It's kind of half and half. And down to his sandals and peg holes and no stands, of course, but he stands pretty well. So he's not wearing much, so it's not as if I can tell you much more about it. Yeah, we obviously get some hair paint there on the body. He's a bit hairy-beary there everywhere, but other than that, pretty solid. And articulation-wise, you can see big ball joint on the neck. Arms pretty solid again, really flexible movement. They've obviously really, I'm sure this is brand new, this sculpted part up there actually. Bicep swivel, double joints at the elbows, and you can see swivel at the wrist and back and forth. We've got a ridiculous ab crunch, so plenty of movement forward and back, like ridiculous, absolutely. Plus a waist swivel, usual stuff, pins up at the top of the legs, double joints at the knees. There is also a swivel at the top of his sandals. And a rocking ankle and pet calls, as I said. So that's pretty much it for Hercules. Quicksilver from the Age of Ultron movie. So again, this is the Infinity series, or Infinity Saga, I should say. Quicksilver, we get a lovely box with a varnished cover in detail on it. We get that artwork that I mentioned before just recently on the Ironmonger video. My figure of the year for Marvel Legends. Absolutely stunning. And we get the logo on the back, or the logo, the movie poster on the back. I always loved that movie poster. There was so much packed in there. But there we go. Very cool. And a little bit about Quicksilver there, which really tells you nothing. And UPC. I would have loved if they put inside the back of this the actual movie print. That would have been great to have the figure standing in front of that kind of poster. It would have just, but nope, sadly not. We get inside the kind of hammer, we get Marvel's kind of logos for the characters, Hulk and Iron Man and stuff, but that's it, not much really on the box, to be honest. However, Quicksilver really comes with quite a few extras. He comes with quite a couple of pieces and parts of Ultrons, or Ultron drones. If I zoom in a little bit, you'll see this a little bit better. We get a nice kind of, it's a very dark paint that's been applied and on top of the silver, but you get a, it's just nice to get these extra Ultron parts and pieces. And you get a body part. It's not much use, the body part, the head alone was useful, but the rest is just parts lying around his feet, I guess. You can have him do, so a little bit of detail in there, but very, very dark on the paint and the plastic, and we get an Ultron arm. And it looks as if it's articulated, or was at one point in the middle there, you'll see, but sadly it's not. It doesn't, or mine won't anyway, so I'm wondering whether it's, yeah, it's kind of gummed up with paint, so there's no way this is moving, but it looks as if the used parts, but I don't recognise that from any other Ultron we've had in the past, movie-wise. But yes, nice little parts and components. So you get those three. You also get a couple of swap-out hands. You can either have two pointy pew-pew hands or two fists with these little gloves that he's got on. And onto the figure, the facial sculpt is nothing like him. But I think they've done a good job of the facial sculpt as a person. It's got the bum fluff going on around, the stubble, the blue eyes. The hair's a bit wild, but then his hair was a bit wild in that movie. And it's not bad. It's just not a million miles close to him, really. It just could be any other character, but it doesn't look too bad. I think they actually captured what is quite difficult here not too badly. But it's just, it's lost something there, I think, in the... I don't think it's quite photoreal myself, maybe. Maybe it is in parts, it turns at angles, but there you go. He's got a kind of, he's got his Quicksilver gear on, got that little silver flash in there, kind of nod to the original character from the comics, and all the kind of stitching, and there's lots of kind of fabric folds nicely done, nice little treads across the pants slash trousers, which is a nice little touch. And down to the shoes, which are painted fluorescent green, which were on my metallic stand there a minute ago, as and really reflecting the green, as you'll see underneath, so that was kind of interesting. They're really, really powerfully green. And that looks kind of good. They look kind of nice. Nice kind of to see a character with trainers on, or sneakers. And that's it. Not much else to show you really on the character. Pretty standard articulation, as we've seen. Ball joint is on a peg up at the top there. Plenty of range and movement. We've got an ab crunch up at the top, which is pretty reasonable. And just like Thor, Hercules, we had the same bicep swivel, shoulder joint, bicep swivel, double joints at the elbows, and wrist have both swiveling back and forth. I've mentioned the upper abs. And you've got a swivel waist and the same stuff. Pegs up at the top of the legs, thigh cut to swivel, double joints at the knees, and down to rocking ankles, and really chunky peckles, very movable. So it's quite a cool figure, but I just, not mega essential, but still, I think with the right poses next to Wanda, it's not a bad figure at all. It's definitely not bad. Neither are bad at all, but they're more very, very fan-specific. If you like those characters, then you'll love them. But for a lot of people, I suspect, it's like, maybe not my bag. But still, put a link below to pick them up. DarkSideToys.com is where I got them. Hopefully you can get them there. And if not, there'll be a link to eBay. But we'll see you for more Marvel Legends and other figures coming out soon. Cheers.